Good morning, guys. So where are we off to today? Well, I have a trailer and I have my crane. So let's see what we're gonna go pick up. It might be an interesting one. Let's go. Let's see what we have. See what our fancy project is. Recognize this area is where I do a lot of the pipe casings and welding. A lot of core barrels. Check out this big old thing right here. Humongous belling tool. For those that know what that is. These guys, they flare out and create a upside down funnel shape inside these shafts. But anyway, this is what I'm after right here. This old little guy right here. It's a Miller something or other. What is this guy? A big 40. This poor thing, you know, has been sitting here forever. And it doesn't run. But I don't think it'll run. But I mean, who knows, right? So we're gonna look into it and see what it's got. Wonder if this is. Hopefully the engine didn't crack. Just empty. Move this guy over. Hopefully no possums come out after me. These open. Well, I'll figure it out later. Anyway, so the goal is to probably have to detach a trailer and come out here with the truck and reach over with the boom, hook onto it, carry it over, put it onto the trailer. So let's go ahead and work on that. I'm gonna look over this area, make sure I don't run into any rebar or anything like that. Looks clear. Okay, let's take off that trailer. Thank you. I don't know if we're gonna be able to reach over that. It's a pretty far stretch and these guys are heavy. Let's find out. Let's give that a shot.
Thank you.
Okay, well, my truck didn't like that at all, but it worked. So we just got it kind of held on there cheesily a little bit just to kind of get it out of this area. So I'll try and drive as slow as possible and get rid of all this stuff. But not bad. I was surprised it did it. It almost didn't want to. Okay, let's carefully move it over.
Let's get the air hose out. We're gonna blow off all the junk off of it.
Okay.
I know I could have done it before I got it on the trailer, but I didn't. Okay, so we got that loaded up. I could have blown it off before we put it on the trailer, but I didn't want to make that noise. And so here we are, opened up the sides, and who knows what this thing is in the condition that it's in. I don't actually know what engine it is. It's a 162 or 163, not exactly sure. And I don't actually know what's wrong with it. And so I really don't know which direction to go with it. I mean, I don't know if we should attempt to get that running, or maybe it was a motor issue, so it's hard to say. My thoughts were to use the engine possibly for my forklift, so that's why I got it. I know there are a lot of rebuild kits for it, and it's a real easy thing to do, so that was my ideas, at least for now. Ooh, see how much water's in here. What's got water? I think it's got water, but it's also got oil, so I guess that's good. So we will have to see. I'm not familiar with these big 40s, but they're pretty cool. Make sure no wasps. It's kind of interesting. Have a possum come jump out at me. Either way, very simple machines, big selectors. Oh, that thing's rusted. So maybe it'll be a good engine for my forklift after all. That's the serial number. I wonder if that's the year. It's got 72. Yeah, 72. It's a 50-year-old machine. Still a spring chicken like myself. Either way. So we're gonna tie this thing down and get it back to the house, see what happens from here. So let me know in the comments what you think I should do with it. And I don't know, it's kind of a cool machine. Yeah, you don't see too many big 40s, and maybe there's a reason for that though. Okay, so let's finish this up and head on out.